one roof, creating the famous Harley-Davidson sound.
And tonight, WISN Total News' Marianne Lyles gets rare access inside the Menominee Falls plant where the heart and soul of Harley is made.
It's the big black Harley-Davidson sign spotted along Highway 45. But what happens inside the Pilgrim Road powertrain facility is typically kept from the public. But now, the general manager is taking us inside.
What I often hear from people that come through that aren't familiar with what we do is how squared away, how clean, how organized the work environment is.
John Lowry considers the plant a second home. Originally from the East Coast, he fell in love with Harley long before working for the motorcycle maker.
I sought out Harley-Davidson. I had no ties personally to Wisconsin, but I am very passionate about the motorcycle.
Lowry beams when describing the assembly line that cranks out the powertrain that's the Harley engine and transmission.
For me, it's the centerpiece of the Harley-Davidson motorcycle. It's not only a functional mechanical thing that, you know, propels your motorcycle, but it's also a thing of beauty.
Obviously, when inside, I'm wearing these glasses, earplugs to protect myself, but this band around my watch, the one around my ring, it's to protect the parts, because as soon as they see a scratch, they stop and have to start over.
You look at the cosmetic quality, the chrome, the paint, the highlighted cooling fins. It's very cool. It's very cool to be a part of it.
Shiny parts, a Harley staple for decades, assembled with today's computers. About 1,000 workers produce 1,000 powertrains a day, 69 different kinds. They'll go to bikes driven all over the world, delivering that famous Harley sound.
That sound, that potato, 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 that's created by the powertrain.
Lowry says it's these parts that have made him so loyal.
I've been riding for a long time and plan to ride for many, many years to come.
An American icon, 110 years and counting. In Menominee Falls, Marianne Lyles, WISN 12 News.